Chapter 3. Why do I gain weight in the summer?
It's summertime. What is it about summer that makes us so happy? The winter is cold, the spring is rainy. Ah, but summertime. The schools are closed, the days are long, hot dogs, hamburgers, corn on the cob, and watermelon. There are parties, concerts, and vacations. Ah, summer. I love summer so much, my only goal leaving high school was to move to South Florida, Fort Lauderdale to be exact. It took a couple of years, but I finally moved there following Hurricane Andrew in 1992. See, in South Florida, it's summertime in January. Yes, the days are shorter, but not as short as up north, because the sun is closer. When I was younger, summer meant freedom from school. I would wake up, eat a bunch of food, and the adventure would begin. My brother Bill and I would hunt frogs, go fishing, split wood, and ride our dirt bikes. When we returned home after our day of fun, we would shovel in as much food as we could and tell the family about our adventure. We played hard, we ate hard, we slept hard, and our lean, muscular bodies always felt refreshed. I think part of my dream of moving to Florida was that I would be able to relive my younger years. I was lucky enough to travel bi-monthly to Key West and enjoy its unique and quirky funkiness, as well as the rest of the state of Florida. The problem was, I got fat. How did I get fat? In South Florida, many local people look like supermodels, and I resemble a manatee. What was I doing wrong? I mean, it's summertime year-round. Yes, I will admit I consume mass quantities of conch chowder, bimini bread, and rum cocktails, but it's summertime. I talk to many people about losing weight, and they all say that you pack on the pounds in the summer. I did as well. But why? People are more active in the summer. We ride bikes, ride horses, do lawn work, swim, play with the kids if you have them. Yes, it is true. Early settlers would fatten up in the summer and fall to make it through the long, cold winter. But we have heat and air conditioning. I believe if you're packing on pounds in the summer, it's because your body is in what I call crisis mode. So you ask, what's crisis mode? Also, you're thinking, is he really going to put crisis mode in quotes for the rest of the book? Because that'll drive me crazy. Crisis mode is probably best described by an unrelated example. If you keep track of your gas mileage in your car, my Toyota averages 31 miles per gallon, you will notice a drop in miles per gallon if you're due for a tune-up, low on oil, your coolant level is low, or needs to be changed. Your car is being asked to run under duress situations, aka crisis mode. So how does your body react when it's in crisis mode? What causes the crisis mode, and how can we fix it? Your car surrenders its miles per gallon. Our bodies, in an effort to survive, produce fat. Nonsense, you say. Why would my body produce fat? Well, if your body's not receiving all of its daily requirements, it will take as many nutrients as possible and turn them into fat in hopes of your survival. When your body's functioning properly, it will take the food you have consumed, create energy, and what it doesn't use is eliminated via waste. Obviously, this doesn't apply if you eat three pizzas. We are talking a reasonable amount of food. When your body is overheated, overextended, overexhausted, it will go into crisis mode. Side note, I lost 20 pounds this summer, and you can too.